If we look under View, we have Grid, Display Grid, Snap to Grid, and Grid to Front. We also have Snap Lines, which has similar features, Display Snap Lines, Snap to Snap Lines, and Snap Lines to Front. Another way of looking at these is in the toolbars. We've got the Options toolbar, which has those same icons and the same features. Display Grid, Display Snap Lines, Snap to Grid, Snap to Snap Lines. To tell whether the features are turned on or not, I'll click on this. When my arrow's over it, I see an outline, but until I click on it, it doesn't turn gray. Now it's gray. I've turned on the grid, and we can see the grid here on the page. But this next one over, Display Snap Lines, when I click that on, we can see that it's gray with the outline, and I don't see any snap lines. That's because we have not added them yet. We need to go into Insert, Insert Snap Point Line. Now I'm going to add a snap line at the 1-inch mark, and we'll make this vertical. Now we can see our snap line. And if I add another page, Insert, Slide, if I add another slide, when I go down to the second slide, that will show it as well. We haven't added anything on the page, so let's put a rectangle on there. And we can use our snap lines to position things just as we would the grid right now. And we can use that as a guide to line things up. But if we really want to use it to line things up, we'll turn on this little magnet, Snap to Grid. Well, I'm going to snap to the snap lines right now and show as we get close, it kind of locks in there. So now we can have our objects snap in at the same position. So we're on our first slide. When I go down to the second slide, let's say I'll add in maybe a triangle. And I want to snap this to the same position. I'll add this cross and one more, and they all snap into that line there, and we can see how well they line up. Now we may want to add a second line, so I would say Insert, Insert Snap Lines, and we'll set this other one at about 5 inches vertical. And we can put more things there that line up and snap in. So we can have multiple snap lines is what I'm getting at. We can do the same thing with a horizontal snap line. Maybe we'll put it, let's have to put this one on Y. Maybe 3 inches. And we can do the same thing. And we see on every page at 3 inches, we have our vertical snap line. We can also insert a snap point. Let's add one at 6 and 2. And here's our snap point. Now if I right click on the snap point or any of the snap lines, I can delete the snap line or I can edit it, which brings up my snap line dialog box, and I can change the position. Maybe I'll make it 5 and it jumps down. I can also use my arrow and drag and drop it around the screen. So on our second slide, we've got a lot of these all lined up to the snap lines. If I make these snap lines invisible by clicking on the display snap lines to toggle them off, now when I move these around, they no longer snap to that area. So I need to have the snap lines showing, and I need to have the magnet on, the snap to snap lines activated. I'm going to turn off the snap lines for now. And let's take a look at the grid. We went up to the view and we saw that we had grid to front. We also had snap lines to front. They basically do the same thing. If I move the grid to the front, it does exactly what you'd think. It moves our grid in front of our shapes. So that might help us line things up a little better. I am going to turn off the grid to front And I'm going to turn on the snap to grid. You can see that that's dark now and outlined. As I move my circle around, I can kind of tell that it's snapping to the grid. But to emphasize the point a little more, I'm going to change my grid. To do that, I'll go into Tools, Options, and then I'm under LibreOffice Draw, Grid. And here we can see that our grid lines are every half inch, 0.5 of an inch. And we're going to have 10 subdivisions of that line. I'm going to change this to 1 for the horizontal and 2 for the vertical. And I'm also going to change my snap range to make this about 20 pixels. Now, if I go back to this box up here and move this around, we'll notice that the box is a little bigger than the half inch. It falls over. So when I move it to the left, it locks on the left. If I move it to the right, it locks to the right. Or if I move it a little more to the right, it locks right there. So we might want to have our box the same dimensions as our grid. So I'm going to add a new one and have it just lock in the entire time. Now when I move it, it goes the half inch to the right or the quarter inch down and locks into the grid. So you might want to keep that in mind if you're using a grid for positioning. The next thing we're going to look at is this help lines while moving. Clicking that turns on help lines as I move an object around the screen. Let's say that we add a new triangle onto the screen. And now we want to position this under our oval. Actually, this is pretty big. We could probably line this up under the rectangle. I might have to shrink it down a little to get it to fit. And we'll do the same with the oval. We'll make this fit exactly in the lines. So we can see how those help lines actually help line things up under the right grid lines, or however we want to use these. The grid lines don't have to be on for this to work.